Fine, so yesterday I had talked about basics of OOPs, object oriented programming, basic drivers, and we had an issue yesterday. Okay, that is, just hold on. Right, we had an issue yesterday that I made this class and I told you that you can have Firefox written in the browser, but you have to use the browser very dynamically. Okay, but right, and you, this code was kind of repeating itself again and again. So I told you that we don't want to repeat this code again and again. Right, what we want is that a single script should be executing everything. Right, you just need to change the browser name out here. The answer to that comes from the concept of interfaces. Okay, I will talk about interfaces now. Fine, for example, I'll create a new interface. Okay, now what is an interface? Interface is something which tells us what the system is doing. Right. For example, if you want to buy a book for yourself from the market, you first look at the cover face of the book. The cover face of the book gives you a brief idea that what book is about. So similarly, the concept of interface is there. Interface tells you that what the system is doing. Fine. For example, I will make an interface known as car. A very simple example. Fine. And an interface would be generated. Right. And what are the features of the car? The features of the car are public void move, public void stop, something like this. So in an interface, you just declare your methods, right? You just define them, sorry, you just define your methods in the interface, right? You don't have any method bodies. You just tell that, fine, these are the methods in this particular interface. So when a layman, he looks at the interface, just by looking at the method names, he can tell that fine what that method is about. Okay, and what the interface is representing. Fine, an interface is always implemented in Java. For example, I'll create a new class and I will name that class as Maruti Car or simple Maruti. Right, so what will happen is that you will have this class, and what you will do is that public class Maruti, you will write implements car. So when you write implements car, you mean that Maruti class will implement all the functions of the car interface. It becomes mandatory for a class, if it is implementing an interface, then it becomes mandatory for the class to implement all the functions of the interface. Okay, if you move your mouse over this, you'll get the option add unimplemented methods. When you click on it, the error will also go. So these are both the functions coming from the car interface into the Maruti car class. You have to implement both of them. You cannot skip. If I remove any one of them, I will get an error. Okay? Right. Now what is this @ override? This sign means that the function is coming up from the interface car. When a layman will look at your code, he will automatically judge, and he will judge that fine, that this function is coming up from the car interface when he looks at the override sign. You can remove it as well. Okay, this is known as an annotation. It will not matter. Okay. And you print over here. Car moving. Car stopping. Okay. Right. So how do we use it? Okay, I'll tell you in some time. Similarly, I can create a new class, a new car like Audi. Fine. Audi class will also implement the interface car. So when it is implementing the car interface, it has to again implement all the functions. And inside it you can write Audi moving and Audi stopping, right? Okay, so each of the function names in both the classes are same, right? The function names are same, but the implementation is differing in both the classes. Okay, so what I did was that, so what I did was that I made one interface, right, and I made two classes which were implementing that interface. Okay, these two classes were implementing the interface. Now what did I achieve by doing this? Okay, I could have never made the interface and only made these two classes. What did I achieve by writing this implements car and all? I could have never implemented the car interface, just made the functions and that's it. The thing is, this kind of a scenario gives an order to the system. If tomorrow a third car comes up, right, if you implement the interface, you will know that what are the functions in that car. The function names move and stop, they remain the same. Okay, so even if you add 10 more cars, you don't have to worry, all of them will be implementing that interface and all of them will be having same set of functions. The implementations will vary across them, but the function names would remain same. Just by looking at the car interface, anybody can tell that fine, these two functions will surely be under these classes which are implementing the car interface. I hope you got my point. Right. Similarly, in Selenium, fine, if you go to the official documentation of Selenium, if you go to the website seleniumhq.org, okay, and if you go to this official Selenium website, you go to the download link and you go to the Java doc over here, documentation, right? And in this documentation, whatever is written in italics is an interface. Okay, like a common example which I always give people, for example, out here, this mouse, it's written in italics, it's an interface. interface representing the basic mouse operations. Okay, right. And there are few basic functions like click, context click, all the mouse functions are there. And these are the two classes which are implementing the mouse interface. Right. Okay, as I told you, everything in Selenium is inbuilt. You need to know the object-oriented principles to just understand it. So whatever in this documentation is in italics is an interface, and you will also get the implementing classes and all. You'll also get the functions which are there in the interface. Similarly, everybody has heard about the word web driver. Okay, technically web driver, in the documentation it is here, it is an interface. Web driver is an interface technically, and all my driver classes, they implement the web driver interface. So if I have to say click on a link in Chrome, or if I have to click on a link on Firefox or IE or any browser, the function name would be the same. In this interface web driver, you have got various functions. For example, close. This will close the current window. So this close function would be there inside every particular driver class. So if you have to close the Chrome, you can use that close function for Chrome, for Firefox, for IE, for any browser. I hope you are getting my point. Fine. So all the classes out here, they are all the driver classes, they are implementing this web driver interface, and this web driver interface has got many functions which will be available to all the driver classes. Okay, right. For example, a function like find element, it finds an element on a page, a link, a button, anything. So this function would be there for every driver class. Okay, right. A function like get title. So if you want to get a title in Chrome or Mozilla or Firefox, you can get it from here very easily. Okay, right. Now moving ahead, if I make a new class known as test, and over here if I create the object, okay, of the interface, for example I write car C equals to new car. Look, in Java you cannot create the object of an interface. You will get an error. Interface is something which is incomplete. Car interface is just giving the method names, that's it. That these are the names which will be present. Okay. So it doesn't make any sense to initiate the car object. That's why you cannot create the object of an interface. But you can create the objects of the classes implementing the interface. Like this. You can write a dot stop and a dot move, you can call. Similarly, you can create the object of Maruti class. And you can call Maruti dot stop like this. The function names would be the same in both the classes. Okay, but when you run it, the implementation will be different. It will print Audi stopping, Audi moving, and Maruti stopping, Maruti moving. Fine. Okay, now suppose the Audi class, it can actually go and implement a function of its own as well. Public void say GPS, something like this, a feature which is not there in the other car, but this is an additional feature, a proprietary feature of the Audi car, right? Fine. Fine. So you can have a functions apart from the overridden, that means the functions coming from the interface. You can have functions which are other than those as well inside the implementing class. So out here in test.java you can have the function over here, you can call it dot GPS. I actually ended up, hold on, where did I put that function? Just a minute guys. Okay, I accidentally deleted it. Okay, so audi.gps, you can call that function as well. Which object creation you are not able to understand? I couldn't get you. Look, you simply create the objects of the classes which are implementing the interface, and you can call the functions inside that classes, right? Okay, you will have access to the proprietary as well as the functions like stop and move coming from the interface. Okay, now coming over to our problem which I had discussed over here, that you have a browser name and you want to open that particular browser very dynamically. You don't want to repeat the code again and again, although the functions in all the three driver classes are same. Like if I want to navigate to a website using Firefox IE or Chrome, the get function is used always. This get function is used. But how do I eliminate or how do I prevent myself from writing this repetitive code again and again? Right, again the answer comes up from the concept of interface out here. Okay, now listen to this carefully. Many people, they get confused out here. I'm going to create the object of the Audi car in a different way. I will write car C equals to new Audi. Now what am I doing? This is the reference of the interface equals to the object of the interface, object of the class implementing the interface. The references of the interface, okay, out here the reference was of the Audi class only. Out here the reference is of the interface and the object is of the class which is implementing the interface. How is this line different from this? It is almost same, but the only thing is that with C you can access the functions in the Audi class coming up from the interface, but you will not be able to access the proprietary functions. You cannot write c.gps. When you create the object like this, you can access all the functions in the Audi class coming from the interface, but not the proprietary function. This you cannot access. Okay, but what is the usage of this then? You cannot access this function, then why do we use this? We use this because the interface reference we have over here. I can also write like this, car C1 equals to new Maruti. Again, in C, with C1 I can access the functions, right? Okay, inside the Maruti class coming from the car interface I can write c1.move. So if I run this, in the end you will see that it's printing Maruti moving, राइट ओके बट इफ आई वॉन्ट देन ऑन द नेक्स्ट लाइन आई कैन मेक सी वन पॉइंट टूवर्ड्स ऑडी सो द सेम ऑब्जेक्ट रेफरेंस आई कैन मूव टूवर्ड्स ऑब्जेक्ट्स ऑफ डिफरेंट क्लासेज इम्प्लीमेंटिंग द इंटरफेस बोथ ऑडी एंड मारुति आर इम्प्लीमेंटिंग द इंटरफेस राइट सो इफ आई राइट सी वन डॉट मूव ओवर हेयर दिस विल प्रिंट ऑडी मूविंग सो इफ आई रन दिस कोड यू विल सी दैट फर्स्ट इट प्रिंटेड मारुति मूविंग बिकॉज सी वन वॉज पॉइंटिंग टूवर्ड्स द ऑब्जेक्ट ऑफ मारुति देन इट प्रिंटेड ऑडी मूविंग बिकॉज सी वन वॉज पॉइंटिंग टूवर्ड्स द ऑब्जेक्ट ऑफ ऑडी Fine. Okay. So this is how the implementation has to be done. Okay. You take the reference of the class in implementing the interface, right, and make that reference point towards any class. I can write like this, say car. C2 equals to null. What does this means that? This means that C2 is not pointing towards any particular object. Based on our requirement, okay, whatever is my requirement, based on that, I can make C2 point towards a new Maruti class. Or I can make C2 point towards new Audi class. It is completely your choice. Okay. Right. Look, you cannot create the object of the interface. Okay. You cannot create the object of the interface like I told you. You can create the object of the classes implementing the interface. Over here, I am creating the object of the classes implementing the interface. I am able to access all the functions. Over here, I have changed the story. I have taken the reference of the class of the interface pointing towards the implementing class. With that, I can only access the functions which are coming from the interface in this class. But this way, I can make my reference point dynamically towards any implementing class. Now we know that in Selenium WebDriver is an interface. I can write like this WebDriver say D equals to new Firefox driver. Right? Okay. Let me include the jar files of Selenium, hold on. Look, I just don't want to jump over to some live example or live project, right, or some scenario. I don't want to jump directly to that because without these basics you will not be able to understand. Okay, right, so you import Firefox driver, you import web driver. So this driver is now pointing towards Firefox driver. Based on my requirement, maybe on the next line I can make driver point towards new, right, new Internet Explorer. Okay, if you just write half the name and if you hit control spacebar of the keyboard, you will get all the options. All the class name options starting with this letter. Okay, so if I keep on typing, it will keep on filtering it. You need to hit the control spacebar. So I can make driver D point towards new Internet Explorer driver, or driver do point D point towards new Chrome driver as well. Okay, maybe I can declare my web driver D equals to null in the beginning, and then I can make D point towards any driver of my choice. With this you can access the functions in the driver classes coming up from the interface. You cannot access the proprietary functions of these classes, and luckily we don't have any major proprietary function in these classes. Okay, so you will have all the three drivers, you have all the three drivers implementing the interface, and with this you can dynamically point toward any driver class. Now coming over to our problem which we had discussed yesterday, fine, Selenium Basics, I'll copy this and I'll paste it over here. Okay, coming over to this problem, so what we will do is that we will declare our web driver object over here, say equals to null, that is it is not pointing towards any particular any particular driver class based on my requirement. Okay, right, I will make the driver, if it's Firefox driver, then I'll make the driver point towards Firefox driver object. Otherwise I will make the driver point towards Chrome driver. So you don't have to worry now. Okay, or I will make the driver point towards, hold on just a minute, I think I made a mistake. Yeah. Okay, I did not give the path of Chrome driver exe as well. I'll give that, hold on, driver point towards Chrome driver, or I can make my, you don't need these two lines, driver point towards Internet Explorer driver. Okay, look guys, for Chrome driver, as I had told you, you need to write this line, give the path of exe file path for the Chrome driver, that is required, without that Chrome will not initiate. But based on my requirement, Firefox, Chrome or I can make the driver point, and then I can write the regular functions, for example driver dot get to the website http, the protocol is important, yahoo.com, and after going to yahoo.com you print driver dot get title. The functions will be same in all the driver classes because all of them are implementing the web driver interface, and using the interface reference you can dynamically open the browser as well. Once the browser is opened in this much script, you can take the browser to any website of your choice, get the title and probably interact with the elements as well. So if I run this code, this will now open Firefox because my browser name out here is Firefox. So when I run this code, you will see that a blank Firefox will be opening and it will be taking you to yahoo.com. Okay, right, and it will give you the title of Yahoo as well. Similarly, if I make it Chrome, if I just change the parameter over here, this parameter later on we can read it from the Excel file or anything, and we can open the browser, and when you run it, now the Chrome browser will open. You see that, and it goes to same Yahoo, same thing is repeated. It will give you the title of Yahoo website as well. Okay, so this is how you work with interfaces. This is the advantage of interface. Now how do you interact with the elements on the web page? There can be a link, button, text field, any element, or any there can be any element on the web page. ओके यू वॉन्ट टू इंटरैक्ट विद दैट एलिमेंट, हाउ डू यू डू दैट? ओके वेल